This is the first in a series of lectures about chemistry. In this lecture, we'll look at the basics of chemistry.
This is an overview of the organization of life, beginning with the atom, which is the smallest particle, all the way up to the organism, which is a group of organ systems in an individual. Be sure you know each of these terms and how they relate to one another.
In order to understand chemistry, we need to look at how chemistry is organized. Part of that organization is a table called the periodic table. This is where there is an ordered arrangement of atoms going from low to high atomic number. Atomic number is the number of protons. In all, there are about 118 known chemical elements. The first 92 elements are naturally occurring, and number 92 is the element uranium, chemical symbol U. All the other elements beyond this are man-made. An element is a substance that cannot be broken into any other substance by ordinary chemical means. An atom is the smallest particle into which a substance can be divided and still retain its chemical properties. A molecule is a group of atoms that are bonded together by energy and act as a group. This shows you the ordered arrangement of atoms in the periodic table. An atom, seen on the right, is composed of three subatomic particles: protons, which carry a positive charge and are located in the nucleus, electrons that carry a negative charge and are located in the shells outside the nucleus, and neutrons, which carry no charge and are located in the nucleus. We're going to be doing some calculations, so these are important definitions for you to know. The atomic number of an element tells you both the number of protons and the number of electrons. The atomic weight tells you the number of protons plus the number of neutrons. Here's the element helium, taken from the periodic table. The chemical symbol for helium is capital H, small case e. The atomic number is the smaller number, and the atomic weight is the larger number. So the atomic number is 2, and the atomic weight for helium is 4. This is the element copper, taken from the periodic table. The question is, what is a chemical symbol? It is a one or two letter representation of either the English or the Latin name of an element. In this case, for copper, it's capital C, small case u. The first letter is always capitalized, the second letter is always a small case letter. This represents helium from the periodic table. Capital H, small case e, is the chemical symbol for helium. What is the atomic number? It is always the smaller number, and it represents the number of protons or electrons in an element. In the case of helium, the atomic number is 2. Here again is the chemical symbol for helium. With it are two numbers, 2 and 4. Remember, the smaller number is always the atomic number, and the larger number is always the atomic weight. So the atomic weight for helium is 4. Here is the chemical symbol for sodium, capital N, small a. This comes from the Latin name natrium. I want you to be able to calculate the following numbers: the number of protons, the number of electrons, and the number of neutrons. See if you can do this before I give you the answer. Since the smaller number, or the atomic number, always represents the number of protons and the number of electrons, the smaller number was 11. So there are 11 protons and 11 electrons in sodium. The number of neutrons has to be calculated. In this case, you would subtract the smaller number from the larger number, or the atomic number from the atomic weight. So 23 minus 11 leaves 12. There are 12 neutrons in sodium. Here is a drawing of a sodium atom showing the electron shells. The four innermost electron shells in atoms are the K shell, or the number 1 shell, the L shell, or number 2 shell, the M shell, or number 3 shell, and the N shell, or number 4 shell. Electrons are located in these shells. The innermost electron shell is the K shell, and it can hold a maximum number of 2 electrons. The second shell, or the L shell, holds a maximum number of 8 electrons. The third shell, or the M shell, holds a maximum of 18 electrons, and the fourth shell, or the N shell, holds a maximum of 32 electrons. On the left is an atom of helium taken from the periodic table. Can you diagram an atom of helium? The place to start is with the nucleus. If you draw the nucleus, you need to determine how many protons there are and how many neutrons there are. The protons are indicated by the smaller number, or 2, so P equals 2 in the nucleus. The number of neutrons is determined when you subtract the smaller number, the atomic number, from the larger number, the atomic weight. So 4 minus 2 gives you 2 neutrons in the nucleus. Remember that the atomic number also tells you the number of electrons. So draw the first electron shell, or the K shell. Know that it will hold a maximum of 2 electrons, and helium has 2 electrons, which you should then place in this first electron shell, or the K shell. You should know that there are 3 types of chemical bonds. An ionic bond, in which electrons are transferred from one atom to another atom. Covalent bonds, in which electrons are shared by atoms, and it's the strongest of the bonds. And hydrogen bonds, in which electrons are shared by hydrogen and small electronegative atoms. And the hydrogen bond is the weakest bond. You should also know the difference between an atom and a molecule. An atom is the smallest particle into which a substance can be divided by ordinary chemical means. A molecule is a group of atoms that bond together and act as a single unit. When you look at a chemical formula such as this, 6NaH2SO4, you need to be able to determine the number of molecules and the number of atoms. The number of molecules is indicated by the number in front of the molecule. The number of atoms is indicated by adding together the number of atoms that compose one molecule. So in the previous example, 6NaH2SO4, there are 6 molecules. Again, remember that's the number in front. How many atoms are in one molecule? Well, there's 1 sodium, 2 hydrogens, 1 sulfur, and 4 oxygens. If you add those up, that totals 8 atoms in one molecule. Then how many total atoms are there? You simply take the number of molecules, which is 6, times the number of atoms in one molecule, which is 8, and multiply. So 6 times 8 gives you a total of 48 atoms.
Both acids and bases are electrolytes, and that means they ionize or they form ions and dissociate, break apart, in water. Acids are proton donors. All acids contain H+ ions. They release H+ in solution. For example, the acid HCl ionizes into H+ and Cl-. Bases are proton acceptors. All bases contain OH- ions. They take up H+ in solution. For example, the base NaOH ionizes into Na+ and OH- when put in water. A salt is formed when an acid and a base combine because they neutralize one another. Because it has a pH of 7, water is considered to be neutral. It's neither an acid nor a base. The same is true of a salt. pH scale is used to measure the hydrogen ion concentration of a liquid, or to tell how acidic or basic a substance is. The scale ranges from 0 to 14, and 7 is neutral. A pH less than 7 is acidic. It donates hydrogen ions. A pH greater than 7 is basic. It accepts hydrogen ions. The lower the pH, the stronger the acid, and the higher the pH, the stronger the base. There's a handout on acids and bases. Please fill it out and submit your answers online. Sometimes there are changes in pH, and they can be dangerous. One way to prevent changes in pH is with buffers. A buffer is a chemical that resists a change in pH.
Water is a very important molecule for us. It composes about 2/3 of our body's weight, and it's necessary for chemical reactions to occur. Water is called the universal solvent because more substances will dissolve in water than in any other liquid. Water helps our cells to hold their shape. Hydrogen bonds hold separate water molecules together. This drawing shows you the structure of 2 water molecules that are bonded together. Remember that separate water molecules are held together by hydrogen bonds, and hydrogen bonds are very weak, so we draw them as a dotted line. Each water molecule, H2O, is held together as a single molecule by covalent bonds, which are stronger bonds. A word commonly used in biology is hydrophobic. Hydro refers to water, and phobia means a fear. So if something is hydrophobic, it means that it has a fear of water. You can see an example of this on the leaf to the right in which the water droplets are beaded up. Another commonly used term is hydrophilic. Again, remember, hydro means water. Philic means love. So if something is hydrophilic, it loves water. In the picture on the right, you can see an example of this. Instead of the water droplets being beaded up, they're spread out across the surface because the surface is hydrophilic. This picture shows you the difference between water on a hydrophilic surface and a hydrophobic surface. If the surface is hydrophobic, it fears water, and water tends to bead up. If the surface is hydrophilic, it loves water, and water tends to spread out across a hydrophilic surface.
Solubility is the ability of a solid molecule to dissolve in a liquid. There is an optional video on solubility that you can view if you choose to do that.
Here are some unique properties of water due to the presence of hydrogen bonds. Water heats up slowly and holds its temperature for a long time. Ice is less dense than liquid water. When water vaporizes, that is, it changes from a liquid to a gas, it removes a lot of energy. Water molecules stick to one another, which is called cohesion, and they stick to other substances, which is known as adhesion. Substances that make hydrogen bonds with water molecules, or hydrophilic molecules, tend to dissolve in water. Substances that do not make hydrogen bonds with water molecules, or hydrophobic molecules, do not dissolve in water.